There's something I seen the other day which I found quite interesting actually. I think it was a news report on RT, good news station by the way. It's a program to watch on that Max Kaiser report. Fucking dapper dude, dapper. But what I noticed was eco-warriors. In the FBI, they label them eco-terrorists. Now, we've been fed an ideology for 10 years now of what a terrorist is. Someone who goes out there and skits those out. And that's the word we're all supposed to look at. But the word that stood out for me the most was eco. That's a shortened version of a single word. And I wondered what that word meant. Now, in my dictionary, Oxford English, it states eco means ecology. But if you scroll down it a bit more, eco is short for economy. Now, I sat there and I looked at it and I thought to myself, what dictionary have the FBI got? Because their dictionary is nowhere fucking like ours. It's nowhere near the same. It's a completely different dictionary. So, I mean, these people think I'm on a different level to other people. They see sinisterism in every single word, in every single action. They see something manipulative in it all. And that's because they've been trained to do it. But have they been trained? Are they something else? But anyway, I was thinking to myself, what are they looking at eco-terrorism as? Are they looking at it as ecology terrorists? And ecology means, give me a sec, ecology, I should have done this earlier, ecology, the branch of biology concerned with the relations of organisms to another and one to their surroundings. In other words, they know that to cut a tree down would be killing us because the tree is essential to our survival as it's sucking in carbon monoxide and giving out oxygen. And we breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon monoxide. So it's a circle of life situation, you get me? And I think I've mentioned that before in a previous video. But anyway, it's a circle of life. But then as you scroll down further, you find out economy's on the list. And that's another shortened version, which means eco. So what I was wondering is, are the FBI looking at people as they're trying to protect the planet? Or people who are trying to attack industry? See, the FBI dictionary, does eco mean in their dictionary economy? Economy terrorists. People who are standing up for life, for the circle of life, are terrorists. But we've been fed that ideology, ideology that terrorists mean danger. But then, you know what? I'm gonna let you watch it. I tried to change it to MP3 so you can see my pretty little face, but I couldn't do it. But anyway, watch the clip. And listen to what the guy says.
When you invade a place for its resources, you wipe out the indigenous population. Those are the rules of any colonization. And right now, we are being colonized.
Okay, did you enjoy that clip? It was a bit of a sneaky clip, don't you think? Think about it. Aliens, if they were going to attack us, they would attack us for our resources. Sorry? What? What is industry doing? What is the government sanctifying? What is religion sanctifying? The cutting down of trees, the stealing of oil, the cutting out of the earth of diamonds, the pollution of water. Isn't that what aliens do? But isn't that what our government's doing? What industry's doing? Therefore, was we invaded a long time ago, killing the indigenous species? We're at war. Every other week there's a new war starting up somewhere. It's something I've thought about quite a bit. I think you might start thinking about it a bit, actually. But they've come here. And it's obvious the government do not think like other people. There's no way they are human, because they're sanctifying the killing of what we need to survive. And they're sanctifying the killing of it. They're sanctifying the cutting out. They'll stand there and claim, oh no, we're not, blah, blah. But the fact is, they're still signing off this country and that country and this country and that country to have whatever is taken away from them for industrial materialism purposes. It's a very sneaky process. And now, okay, now we're going to go a little deeper. We're going to go into the Hilahim or the Anunnaki, whatever they call themselves. But they are apparently the species of planet X. Now the thing is with the Anunnaki, they live long lives. I mean, longer than anyone else. I mean, what we consider, they live long lives. The problem with them living long lives is they get complacent with them. Okay, so in other words, this laptop, they would be happy with for 200-300 years. Before they decide to take it to another level, if they can be asked. However, because we as humans live 100 years, 80 to 100, we live short lives. And we're constantly improving all the time. So this laptop, it's been around for a couple of years, 10 years, 20 years, or 15 years. And we're already trying to improve. We're in fact taking it to another level. We're looking at interactive. We're already experimenting with it. Wiz, you know, you got your laser. The film with Tom Cruise, a Minority Report, where he stands it. And he goes like that with his hand, and a screen pops up in front of him. We're already experimenting with that technology. So this has been around 15 years, but we're taking basically the government we have in now, and they're nowhere near on the same level as us. You know, even though you want to deny it, you still can't deny the fact that you know and you don't want the trees to be cut down. And you will, if push come to shove, you would defend the last tree. But this government has found it's got 6 billion slaves. And that's what you are, people, slaves. It's found that it can manipulate you into cutting down, into killing yourself, into polluting your own water, into cutting your own trees down for a couple of pence, of which it takes back via tax and VAT. I mean, when it landed on this planet, it must have thought, whoa, what's going on here? Because, you know what, these are the dumbest species in the entire universe. Yo, let's just take them for a ride. And that's what we're doing, people. They've taken you for a ride, and you're paying to be taken on this ride. It's got these lovely, nice houses. I mean, Richard Branson paid 120 grand for a bit of mud. It's now worth 90 million. It charges 30 grand a night, 33 grand a night to stop there. I mean, these people, they are not human, they cannot be. I mean, I've got money here, but I will never pay 33 grand for an holiday. The most I'll pay for an holiday is a puncher repair kit, because I'll jump on my motorbike and bugger off with my tent on my back, you know, that's all I have to do. I don't have to pay anything, you know. I pay for it when I get there, because bloody exercise kills me, but you know. Like I said, these people cannot be human. Simple as. Look at that fucking one. It's gone down now. Something wrong with them anyway, because they're not human. Anyway. Anyway, the psychology behind that is out of sight, out of mind. Because what's going on out there is just insane. Left, right and centre. So the reason for my back turn is to shut it out. That's what I've turned me back on the world. Because to be frank, nobody's got the bollocks to stand up. I mean, what makes me laugh is these rioters. Oh shit, there's a uniform. Charging at us. If you're gonna have it, people, fucking have it! Fuck about. You don't live forever, you're gonna die eventually. And it only hurts for a second or two. And in fact, it don't even hurt when it's happening. It only hurts after. Anyway, I got a lot of stuff. By the way, people, you can learn something from the people in the Middle East, because when they start something, they don't stop until it's finished. And for that, I've got a fucking lot of respect for, a lot of love for, but bollocks to see through. And you won't take any bollocks. You know what you want, and you go for it. And I've got to respect them, and you've got to respect them. Anyway, I'm rabbiting on. I've got to lock this off, so I need to piss. I'll catch you on the flip side, yeah? Peace.